ஓம் நம சிவாய. ஹாய் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், ஹவ் ஆர் யூ? இன் திஸ் வீடியோ வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் தம் லிம்ஃபேத்திக் ட்ரைனேஜ் ஆஃப் த மெமரி கிளான். ஓகே, வெரி இம்பார்ட்டண்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் கைஸ், மே பி கிவன் அஸ் த 5 மார்க்ஸ். லிம்ஃபேத்திக் ட்ரைனேஜ் ஆஃப் த மெமரி கிளான். த லிம்ஃப் நோட்ஸ் இன் த லிம்ஃப் நோட்ஸ் ட்ரைனிங் த பிரெஸ்ட். த லிம்ஃப் ஃப்ரம் த பிரெஸ்ட் இஸ் ட்ரைனட் இன் டு தம் ஃபாலோயிங் குரூப் ஆஃப் லிம்ஃப் நோட்ஸ். த லிம்ஃப் ஃப்ரம் த பிரெஸ்ட் இஸ் ட்ரைனட் இன் டு தம் ஃபாலோயிங் குரூப் ஆஃப் லிம்ஃப் நோட்ஸ். See one by one: axillary lymph nodes, internal mammary nodes, supraclavicular nodes, posterior intercostal nodes, and cephalic nodes. These cephalic nodes also called as deltopectoral nodes. See one by one: axillary lymph nodes. Axillary lymph nodes are lying in the axilla and divided into the 5 groups, not 4 guys, total 5 groups: anterior group, posterior group, central group, lateral group and apical group. Okay, these are the 5 groups: anterior, posterior, central, lateral and apical. Anterior group also called as pectoral group, and the posterior group also called as subscapular group, and the lateral group also called as humeral group, and the apical group also called as infraclavicular group. Okay, these are the divisions of the axillary lymph nodes. Next, internal mammary nodes. Internal mammary nodes are lying along the internal thoracic vessels. Internal mammary nodes lying along the internal thoracic vessels. Supraclavicular nodes lying above the clavicle. Supraclavicular nodes lying above the clavicle. Posterior intercostal nodes lying in the posterior parts of the intercostal spaces in front of the head of the ribs. Posterior intercostal ribs lying in the posterior parts of the intercostal spaces in front of head of ribs. And the last one, that is cephalic nodes, and ours deltopectoral nodes lying in the deltopectoral groove. See this figure. This figure explains the lymph nodes that draining the breast. Okay, see here, this is the axillary lymph nodes. Okay, these 5 are the axillary lymph nodes. Okay, apical group. First see here guys, what are the divisions of the axillary nodes, axillary lymph nodes? Apical group, central group, lateral group, anterior group and posterior group. Okay, see here, apical group, central group, lateral group, anterior group, and this is the posterior group. Okay, these are the divisions of the axillary lymph nodes. This is, see here guys, this line represents the clavicle. Okay, this line represents the clavicle, and this is the apical group. Okay, so we call this apical group also as infraclavicular group, because this apical group present inferior to the clavicle, so we call this apical group as infraclavicular group. Next, this is the central group. Okay, next, see here, this is the lateral group. This lateral group also called as humeral group. Okay, this is the humerus. Okay guys, already all knows this. Here humerus bone will present, so we named this lateral group as humeral group. Next, coming here, this is the anterior group. This anterior group of lymph nodes present in the pectoral region. Okay, this is the pectoral region guys, so we name this anterior group as pectoral lymph nodes, a pectoral group. Next, see here, this is the posterior group. This posterior group of lymph nodes also called as subscapular group. Okay, this is about the axillary lymph nodes. Next, see here, this is the supraclavicular nodes. These supraclavicular nodes lying above the clavicle, so we call these supraclavicular nodes. Next, deltopectoral nodes. These deltopectoral nodes lie in the deltopectoral groove, so we call these deltopectoral nodes. These deltopectoral nodes also called as cephalic nodes. Next, these are the posterior intercostal nodes. Okay, these are the posterior intercostal nodes, and these are the internal mammary nodes. These are the internal mammary nodes. Okay, guys. Here, a note is given. In the addition to the above mentioned nodes, the lymph from breast also drain into the subdiaphragmatic and subperitoneal lymph plexus. Once again, in addition to the above mentioned nodes, the lymph from breast also drain into the subdiaphragmatic and subperitoneal lymph plexus. Next, lymphatics draining the breast. Okay, lymphatics draining the breast. The lymphatics draining the breast are divided into two groups, superficial and deep. The lymphatics that draining the breast divided into two groups, superficial group and deep group. The superficial lymphatics draining the skin of the breast except that nipple and the areola. The superficial lymphatics draining the skin of the breast except the nipple and areola. Next, deep lymphatics. Deep lymphatics draining the parenchyma of breast, skin of the nipple and areola. The fluxes of lymph vessels deep to the areola is called subareolar fluxes of Sapir. The fluxes of lymph vessels deep to the areola is called subareolar fluxes of Sapir. The subareolar fluxes and most of the lymph from the breast drain into the anterior group of axillary lymph nodes. The subareolar fluxes and most of the lymph from the breast drain into the, see here guys, most of the lymph from the breast drain into the anterior group of axillary lymph nodes. Okay, anterior group or pectoral group. The fluxes of the lymph vessels that lie deep to the areola. See here guys, here areola will present, this is the nipple. Okay, the fluxes of the lymph vessels that lie deep to the areola, we call that subareolar fluxes of Sapir. Okay, we call that subareolar fluxes of Sapir. And the subareolar fluxes and the most of the lymph that draining into the anterior axillary nodes. These are the anterior axillary nodes. The most of the lymph from the subareolar fluxes and breast. And most of the lymph from the breast drain into the axillary group of axillary lymph nodes. Okay, we call that anterior axillary nodes or pectoral nodes. Okay, clear guys? The superficial lymphatics of the breast of one side communicate with those of the opposite side. The superficial lymphatics of the breast of one side communicate with those of the opposite side. Consequently, the unilateral malignants may become bilateral. Consequently, the unilateral malignancy may become bilateral. Malignancy will become across the in cancer times. See here guys, the lymphatic drainage from breast occurs as follows. The lymph from lateral quadrants of the breast is drained into anterior axillary or pectoral group of lymph nodes. These lymph nodes are situated deep to the lower border of the pectoralis minor. The lymph from the lateral quadrants of the breast is drained into the anterior axillary or pectoral group of the lymph nodes. These lymph nodes are situated deep to the lower border of the pectoralis minor. See this figure guys, this is the lateral. Okay, the lateral part of the breast, the lymph from the lateral part of the breast drain into the anterior group of axillary lymph nodes. Okay, the lateral part of the breast, the lymph from the lateral part of the breast drained into the anterior or late pectoral group of axillary lymph nodes. Next, the lymph from medial quadrants is drained into internal mammary lymph nodes situated along the internal mammary artery. Some lymphatics may go to the internal mammary lymph nodes of the opposite side. The lymph from medial quadrants is drained into internal mammary lymph nodes situated along the internal mammary artery. Some lymphatics may go to the internal mammary lymph nodes of the opposite side. See here, the lymph from the medial side may drain into the internal mammary lymph nodes. See here guys, lymph from the medial quadrants of the breast drained into the internal mammary lymph nodes, and this lymph also drain into the opposite side internal mammary lymph nodes. A few lymph vessels from the lower lateral quadrant of the breast follows the posterior intercostal arteries and drained into the posterior intercostal nodes located along the course of these arteries. A few lymph vessels from the lower lateral quadrant of the breast, lower lateral quadrant of the breast follows the posterior intercostal arteries and drained into the posterior intercostal nodes located along the course of these arteries. See here guys, the lymph from the lower lateral quadrant. See here, the lymph from the lower lateral quadrant may drain it into the posterior intercostal lymph nodes. Lymph from the lower lateral quadrant may drain it into the posterior intercostal lymph nodes. Next, the few lymph vessels from the lower medial quadrant of the breast pierce the anterior abdominal wall and communicate with the subdiaphragmatic and subperitoneal lymph flexes. Some lymph vessels or lymph flexes from the lower medial quadrant may pierce the abdominal wall and communicate with the subdiaphragmatic and subperitoneal lymph flexes. See here, lymph from the lower medial quadrant may drain it into the subperitoneal and subdiaphragmatic lymph nodes. Okay guys, the lymph from the deep surface of the breast pierces the pectoralis major and clavipectoral fascia to drain it into the apical group of axillary lymph nodes. The lymph from the deep surface of the breast pierces the pectoralis major and clavipectoral fascia to drain it into the apical group of axillary lymph nodes. See this figure guys, and the lymph from the deep surface of the breast, okay, the lymph from the deep surface of the breast pierces the clavipectoral fascia. See here, this is the pierces the pectoralis major muscle and the clavipectoral fascia to drain it into the apical group of axillary lymph nodes. Okay, may drain it here. Deep surface lymph from the deep surface of the breast pierces the pectoralis major muscle and clavipectoral fascia to drain it into the apical group of axillary nodes. Understand guys, first this pierces the pectoralis major muscle and then the clavipectoral fascia to drain it into the apical group of axillary nodes. A note is given here guys, about 75% of the lymph from the breast is drained into the axillary nodes, 20% into internal mammary lymph nodes, 5% into the posterior intercostal lymph nodes. Among the axillary nodes, most of the lymph into the anterior axillary nodes, that we already learned. Most of the lymph from the breast is drained into the anterior or pectoral axillary nodes and the remaining into the posterior and apical groups. The lymph from anterior and posterior groups first goes to the central and lateral groups and then through them into the supraclavicular lymph nodes. Okay guys, this is about the lymphatic drainage of the breast. The lymph from the upper lateral quadrant drained into the anterior lymph nodes. Okay, and the lymph from the lower lateral quadrant drained into the posterior intercostal lymph nodes, and the lymph from the upper medial quadrant drained into the internal mammary lymph nodes, and the lymph from the lower medial quadrant drained into the subperitoneal or subdiaphragmatic lymph plexus. Okay guys, and the lymph from the deep surface of the breast drained into the apical group of axillary lymph nodes by crossing the pectoralis major and clavipectoral fascia, like in this figure. Okay guys, if you like my explanation, please like, share and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys.